So, tēnā koutou katoa, welcome to the symposium and book launch for alternative reality gardening. I've got a couple of people here, one of which is my PhD supervisor, so all I can think about is augmented reality right now. So one of the things I want to do today is to talk a little bit about our MAD project. So I'm Maggie from Arfi World, and this is a project that I conceived and curated. And it's a combination of a book and a symposium, and it's an international effort. And I know that those who are joining us here today live, there's a few people from overseas, but those of you who are seeing a recorded version, as you look through, you're going to see a number of different people from around the world, including Brazil and Europe, as well as Australia, and a bunch of people from here in Te Tai Tokoro who are members of the Arfi Incubator Project. So I want to begin by thanking the Ministry of Culture and Heritage for funding the Arfi Incubator Project. Alternative reality gardening is part of an outreach, or part of that particular project, which is designed to showcase the amazing talent we have in our region and connect Te Tai Tokoro to the rest of the world, a region that has been isolated by a number of events in the last few years related to climate change and also COVID-19. And so it's about building resilience in our cross-disciplinary creatives in our region, and also highlighting an area of arts and creative practice that is often not seen as much as others, because it's kind of a bit of an in-between kind of area. So I'll start with going into my slideshow, and I want to give you a bit of an overview of who's behind the scenes of this amazing thing you're about to see, and also give you a bit of a background as to why alternative reality gardening. What I want to start by doing is doing a shout out and acknowledgement to those who have been involved with the creation of the publication that you're going to see, as well as the many different, very rich symposium contributions, which make up a kind of an amazing garden that you can wander through and will be able to see a great deal of knowledge growing in front of you. So the designer of the publication is Jessica Keesing. She lives in Dargaville, and she's been an amazing support to me, having an eye on design and kind of bringing a vision that I had around the look and feel of the publication to life, and also long suffering in terms of multitude of changes and something that we, you know, was a new venture, I think, for both of us. I had edited a book before, but I think this is quite a different kind of publication, as you will see. I also want to thank Jared Taylor, who's Arfi World, a production assistant at Arfi World. He did a lot of the video production and symposium coordination, and a lot of editing, a huge amount of sometimes very creative editing. So thank you very, very much, Jared. And of course, Kim, my partner and partner in crime at Arfi World, who supported curatorially and also was a contributor both in the publication and the symposium. And you'll see an amazing performance by him if you go into the symposium works. In terms of advisory proof and review, we also have Zana Bell, Pete Newland, and Olivia Garelger, all of whom provided kind of a peer review of the content, but also some proofing and various support along the way. Neil Martin provided a little bit of technical support with some of the imagery, and also a shout out to Jesse Gray, who supported the back end in terms of the website in which it sits. We worked with a number of organizations and are working with a number of organizations as part of the Arfi Incubator Project. And those organizations were part of the call out that we did for this strange venture. Seeds is a transdisciplinary network, and a number of people from Seeds are joining us today on this call, but also were contributors either to the book or the symposium or both. And I want to thank them very much for their contribution. We also have Tree Create, Dr. Tracy Benson in Yarun, Boraibi Island in Brisbane, who also created content. Maunga Kura Toi, contributed, and Ako Hokianga, both of whom are organisations who are part of our incubator project and interaction initiatives, were also part of it, and a number of other people representing organisations in of themselves, who we'll hear about a little bit later. And as you can see, it was funded as part of the incubator project, and another shout out, because you can never say enough shout outs to funders, Ministry of Culture and Heritage, who we hope will still survive after the election in October in a couple of weeks' time. So the contributors to the symposium, there's a number, and they fall across a number of different organisations. You'll see them as we go through, and I don't want to go through in too much detail because I kind of want you, as I said, to discover the garden that you're going to see rather than be walked through and pointed out every single plant. But you'll see that there are a number of people from the AFI Incubator Project here. Those are the ones that are asterisks. And those individuals are presenting kind of a snapshot of their research or practice in terms of what they're doing with us, or a little bit of a shout out to their content that they've provided for the publication. We also have some individuals who have been supporting us in mentoring roles and workshops. Dr. Roy Davies is one of those, and also Professor Francis Joseph. We have some individuals from AIDA Aotearoa, Ted and Vicky, who are providing kind of an overview of the cultivation they're doing in their communities. AIDA is a national digital arts organisation of which I used to be the chair. Mark Williams is from a parallel organisation called Circuit Artists Moving Image, and also gives an overview of some of the alternative reality gardening type projects that Circuit has in their database. We have Kate Stevenson from Dot Dot, who's providing something in terms of their own Ministry of Culture and Heritage project, which is around virtual platforms for artists. And we also have some people, as I mentioned earlier, from Seeds. Daniel Vandermessen, who's a very good collaborator of ours, who we've just worked with on a project where it's ended up that we have a flag flying in Belgium with a collaborative work of all things. And you can learn about that on the AFI World website. So thank you to Daniel. And also we've got Mary, who provided a beautiful talk on a meandering through some beautiful philosophical gardens, actually. And the other Seeds people have also contributed to the publication, which you'll see in a moment. The other shout outs I want to do in terms of the symposium is Terry Donaldson, who's from Wharepuke Organics, who's a local organic farmer who talks about alternative reality gardening in terms of being a different kind of gardener in a relatively conservative part of New Zealand. And we have Craig Nielsen, who did a talk for us recently on AI. And so we have a live version of that recorded talk. And Marshall Farrell, who I stumbled upon, I guess if you're wandering around a garden and you find something very precious that you stumble upon, I stumbled upon Marshall when I was reading The Guardian one day. She's a medical psychotherapist, and she's also an avid gardener. And she's talking a little bit about alternative realities, gardening, and a sense of belonging. So you'll see a little bit more about those as you go through the symposium a little bit later. And then in terms of the publication, as I mentioned, we have a number of people from the incubator program who have contributed. And the publication, just like the symposium, is a miscellany. So it's a combination of many different things. It can be poems, it can be parafiction, it can be images, it can be digital images that are taken in a physical form and put into the book, as well as images of physical works that are digitized and then placed into the book. We have a number of different genres in play, and a number of different takes on what different people, whether they be scientists, technologists, or creatives across a wide range of disciplines, understand to mean alternative reality gardening for them. And among these, Natalia Fuentes provides us an example of her recycled 3D printed vases that she's very closely held and loved understanding of propagation through to creations that have happened in 3D of unknown seaweed species or the primordial species that Luca, that kind of the beginning species of how the human race started, right through to different kinds of snapshots of different people's lives, whether that be memories of people passing, relationships with plants and the glitches of that. It could be caring for one's activist mother who's in the latter stages of life. So snapshots of people's lives, including screenshots of their research into space gardening. We have poems, we have fictional stories that meander through different worlds. And we also have examples from BIOS, a recent lab that we conducted earlier this year that has very different examples of fiber through to technology and biology interacting. So there's a very, very wide range of things in the publication, but I actually want to leave you to discover that yourself as we go through later this morning. So a little bit about me and alternative reality gardening. What you see here is an image of me working in Senegal about 20 years ago. And I guess for me, I've had a long-term interest in the planet and in place and how people belong. And so for 30 years, I've been working to open portals between different realities and cultures and locations, with a view to getting people to connect more deeply to place and therefore to connect more deeply to the planet. And so I did a lot of work in Africa and various other places around the world. And then I went to Brussels. I did some work in Brussels and worked with foam, where I met Dr. Angelo Vermeulen, who's one of the contributors to our publication. And as part of that work with foam, I kind of integrated a number of different techniques that I had had from my organizational and community development and facilitation background into my creative and spiritual practice. I then came back to New Zealand and worked in South Auckland while I was caring with my mum. And when I was working in South Auckland, I was lucky enough to be funded by the EU as part of their Culture 2000 project through foam, and part of a project called the Guild of Reality Integrators and Generators. And as part of that, I did the AFI wraparound project in South Auckland with a school who I worked with as part of an integrated curriculum event. So over 3 months, we generated an alternative reality in and around the school called AFI World. And AFI World was a world that embraced us and also supported us to be more sustainable. And we had the police involved and actors and various permaculturalists and different artists who popped through portals and came and visited us alongside the teachers who created curriculum for students to learn. In this case, what you're seeing is an image of them examining portals and doing a forensic evidence gathering exercise around their school to find out what portals were there, what portals involved, and who the creatures were or people that came through. And that was an amazing project, which then kick-started a little bit later, AFI World, the company which I founded and was gifted that name to use. After AFI World, or here's actually Raywin Turner, I should mention her. She was part of that original program. Raywin is very much a transdisciplinary artist, and she led our portal investigation that day. So my PhD actually was on portals, parallel realities. It was on the spirit of place, and it was particularly focused on augmented and geolocative realities. So for me, again, there was a gardening theme, just as it was all along, connecting people to place, but also getting them to think more about the relationship between digital, physical, spiritual, and also flora and fauna that surrounded them. In this case, it was with the PhD, in this case study, working with Papakura Marae to create an alternative reality garden where people could discover a number of stories implanted in the land. Dr. Roy Davies, who's given a symposium talk, was part of that. He was my supervisor, and also his company, Immersia, provided the database and some of the undercurrent in terms of the technology for that. So for me, alternative reality gardening is located within a kind of theory base, which sees the spirit of place no longer as kind of a pure entity or kind of an authentic entity that we enter just simply with flora and fauna. The spirit of place for me includes the buildings that we've created, includes the digital content that overlays those spaces, and it's a much more rich environment that we enter. So for me, alternative reality gardening has always meant some kind of fusion or relationship between the digital and the physical, the spiritual and the social. As part of my PhD, I also did a case study at a local park using VJing, using a number of different tools to investigate that particular site from a number of different mindsets. And so also alternative reality gardening is about opening portals between different mindsets, which is what you'll see when you encounter the symposium and the book, which contain a range of different disciplines as well as cultures from around the world and cultures in terms of practice. What you're seeing here is some mushrooms that I found on that particular site overlaid with archival plans that I found in the research library at Monaco. And so VJing the content on the site, what I did was I mixed together psychic impressions, oral history, archival imagery, drone footage, microscopic analysis on various different ways, and a number of different scientific investigations from soil to microbiology. I also did a number of different kind of photographic experiments on the site and kind of covered as many different disciplines, scientific and artistic, as I could, as well as humanities. And then when I VJ'd it, I mixed all that together very intuitively and put that back into an app. So in terms of the ARFI world itself, we started that in 2014, and my partner Kim and I have been working on that, most of the projects together. And ARFI World has been taking forward the work that I did in my PhD and working with place, particularly as a concept, and doing our own form of alternative reality gardening. This is a site that we worked on in Manurewa, which was a large derelict tower where we created an installation that involves interactive sensors, but also whispers that we gathered from around the area. So it's about, in this case, cultivating a kind of community love for a site and using technology in a way that supports that. Another series of works that we've done has been with youth. I'm using AR to give young people, particularly in their schools, a sense of connection to place. And so we place these around the land. These are markers. Kim doing an amazing job of creating these mad AR apps, and me kind of curating some of the content. And the children do poems and songs and introduce other children to the places that they love. So again, it's like connecting people to land. And I see that as a definitely a form of gardening. In Papakura, we did a series of projects activating spaces and places that people maybe didn't love. This was an alleyway, and this was a giant moth that decided to appear. We've also did sort of geolocated sound projects, again with Immersia, involving placing content, curated content, in different locations of different kinds for people to discover. And this was called Place Stories Matariki, which involved these portals that were created in order for people to then access in various ways. This was the gallery version, and there was an app version that you could wayfind using geolocative technology. We've also worked in rest homes using flora and fauna and activating elders to be connected to emerging technologies. And we've also done installations using algorithms that Kim has created. And you'll see some of those algorithms in his symposium performance, by the way, generated live with sound. And these are plants. This particular one, these plants were gathered during lockdown. We then put an iteration into the gallery so that whenever people walked in, a new form of plant was propagated as they watched, using different bits of plants that people had found. And this was about four or five iterations in this space, using different garden sites around Whangarei, but then also, as I said, people's backyards during the COVID lockdown. More recently, it's been about curating spaces where people connect biology to technology in various ways. And we collaborated with a number of different people on BIOS, which was assisted in terms of FOTHO, who assisted us in production. We connected with Seeds and various others. And what you see there is on the monitor is a virtual reality lab that Frederico Senna in Brazil created for us to access. And we also had Daniel, who I think is on this call perhaps, who created a world in Sansar for us to encounter as well. And so they created their own gardens and different worlds, and we connected to them, sending signals between our space and theirs. And then in my own work, most recently, I've been working with microscopy as well as bioplastics. And Frances Joseph, who's in the symposium, talks about new materials that she's developing. And she introduced me to bioplastics. And I've been doing images using agar in this case to seal plants in the essence, which kind of combines my spiritual practice as well as my interest in creativity. So again, it's connecting to the earth, but using that different kinds of things in an alternative way. So I want to just enter now, all going well, the back area of the site so you can see the publication in the symposium. And I'm hoping that at the moment you're seeing a website load. And if we scroll down, you'll come to the publication and symposium link. And you may not realize it, but you're now inside a portal to an alternative reality. So this is where you will be able to access, first of all, the book. What you'll see here, first of all, is the actual call out. So I'll just skim read through that. Places today formed from multiple intelligences, flora, fauna, signals, encode, and tangle. What's considered true, alive, and beautiful is negotiated. And then I asked a series of questions. What gardens are emerging and what is possible? What is being cultivated? What is thriving? What life forms are emerging? What are you foraging, propagating, or grafting together? And what is your place? And that was essentially the call out for all of the people that you see who contributed to the publication and also to the symposium. So I won't click through the publication now because I'd like people to do that for themselves and kind of get a lovely surprise. I will ask that if you are going to access the publication, you do that through Chrome or Firefox. We prefer that you don't use Edge. Edge doesn't like PDFs that are embedded into website pages. So use those two and it'll make it a much more seamless experience. And also use the option that says even pages. And it'll allow you to go in and there's an embedded PDF. To let you know, we will be doing a physical version of the publication in the coming months, and that will allow people to kind of have that in its own kind of way, and we'll do a limited print so that we'll be able to give a version free to those who participated in the publication, but also sell those to offset the costs for others. Now, as you go through the symposium, you'll see a number of different people. And these are all the links to that. Some of the people involved, for example, Sharon, one of our incubator participants, and Peter Stayett from Seeds, Kim, and I think Daniel Vermeson, they all contributed performances as well as, or instead of talks, or there's a range of things you'll see here. There's recordings of live events, as you see with Craig on the right. There's also insights into research, as you see with Reva. Tracy will be giving an insight into her research, as will Tracy Benson. So Tracy Benson from TreeCreate. There's the interview, I guess we could call it more of a conversation with Marshall, which I conducted after reading her book and reading about her in The Guardian. Terry Donaldson will be talking about her experience, and I'll be doing a bit of an interview with her about her experience as an organic farmer. And as I said, we've got some performances here. Hamish gives an insight into his research. He's got a beautiful contribution to our book as well. There's the contribution from Ada, Mary gives a lovely overview, quite a mesmerizing talk about different experiences of alternative reality gardening, quite philosophical. Kim's performance and talk about his practice, as well as Elise, who's an incubator participant, who has a very interesting alternative reality garden involving alien species. Mark from Circuit, who talks about Circuit moving image. And then we have Roy and Francis, both of whom are colleagues of Kim and I from AUT University when we were working there. And Roy is now at Auckland University, and both of whom are partners in the incubator. What I'll do is I just want to, first of all, thank all of you for coming along. Thank all of you who are here who have contributed as well. I'm excited to see what you think of the work. I know for some of you, it's maybe the first time you might have been published, which makes me feel very, very excited and happy. Certainly for some of you, it might be the first time that you've been involved in alternative reality, anything. So thank you for putting your faith in me and being involved in this very, very mad project. What I would love is for you to now have a look at the book, have a look at the symposium videos, enjoy the content. And if you have any comments or feedback and so forth, please make a comment or let us know what you thought about that. But as I said, enjoy meandering through the garden.